Hi guys, RPM Designs. I decided to make a video about Asus ROG Armoury Crate software. And yeah, it's the most buggy, cancerous software I ever encountered. What I mean with that is that this software spreads like a cancer to your Windows operating system. And here is why. At first I was having problems. These problems date all the way back from 2018. I had mouse issues, lag in games, and I could not figure out what it was. After many reinstalls of Windows, I couldn't find corruptions. I decided there must be or a hardware issue or a software issue. After many hours of research on internet, tried different things, different peripherals, you name it, USB ports, drivers, Windows, whatever, you name it, I tried. Disabling services, enabling services, blah blah blah, the list is on and on and on. Never found a solution until I found a post about Asus AllSuite 3 that is causing issues with the EC sensor. And this EC sensor on Asus, they continuously to use it, and I don't think it's the EC sensor itself, because it's actually an intelligent and pretty good functioning product. It's just the software from Asus itself that is extremely erratic. It can and will cause lots of Windows issues, and it can literally drive you mad. And the software I'm talking about is Armoury Crate. Here it is, this piece of software. And in the name of all that is holy, if you like your system, if you are an enthusiast, if you are a power user, if you want the best performance possible, avoid this. I cannot emphasize enough on how to avoid this like the plague. This is the worst software in the history of softwares, and I'm going to explain why. In order to uninstall it, you need to This is just too ridiculous. I cannot even say it with a straight face. You need to use an Armoury Crate uninstall tool. This tool is needed in order to get rid of this extremely erratic software. I was having not too many issues. I was having some mouse issues when I have Armoury Crate installed, and in Destiny, especially Destiny 2 has a very sensitive game engine, and it causes so many issues. There's just too much. I cannot even cover it in one video. I'm not, like an engineer. I don't have the software to prove, as in, show you the numbers before, after, whatever. It's just, I know that a lot of people have the same issue like me, because I was searching the internet, and I think this is one of the things, especially the most of the issues are from Asus ROG. And I spent like years of researching problems, where it originates from, and I was at overclock.net. And I worked with a guy, an R&D engineer, and we discovered, me and five others, that there was a serious issue with the fan. It's on my YouTube channel as well. I can post a link in the description if you want, but it's in my channel. You can, it's the fan issues, and like the whole system becomes just unstable. Get random reboots. You get, what was it? If you have like a water cooling system, or it doesn't matter, if you use the CPU fan header, it's just so crazy that it can ramp up and down like or it just stops working entirely. And but if you have a water pump, you cannot. Most of the time, I don't even hear my pump. But if I have it connected to my CPU header, it can and will cause problems. And yeah, I don't, some people say they never had issues. I don't know if with the same board, I think, or they are lying, or they simply don't know what the problem is, or because I mean, there's no. Maybe there's a batch a bad batch of these EC sensors. Maybe, I don't know. There's no way of telling this. I can only describe what the problems I was having, and I found a way to fix it. Yeah, these problems were extremely, because I was gaming one day, and all of a sudden my CPU temp went over 80 degrees. I'm like, what the hell? And I could not understand what the cause was. And yeah, I restarted the system. First time it locked up, actually. It went to 95 degrees and I got system restart. The system just shut down. I go, what the hell? And I could not understand what's happening. So I restarted and it happened again. And then I start monitoring my system with Hardware Info 64. And yeah, I saw my CPU temp rise, and I could not figure out what the problem was. Long story short, it was the Armory Crate software. I did not have it. I had it installed and tried to, you know, make it was Asus L Suite. I'm sorry. Excuse me. The Fan Expert. I tried to. Work with it, and yeah, it didn't work, and it was all erratic and crap, and so I deleted it. I uninstalled it with Revo Uninstaller, and in the hope for it to get rid of the software. And I thought it was, and I did say cleaner after it, and yeah, but sure enough, it cleaned everything off. So I thought. I was still having issues, like mouse tracking issues in any other weird stuff going on, and I could not figure out. And then some guy told me that this software is still on the PC. It's still there. I mean, it's all over the internet. Just Google Asus All Suite 3 issues or erratic behavior, whatever you want to Google, and you find tons and tons of people with the same problem. That was the first thing, and then there was a big debate on overclock.net, and there was an R&D engineer, and yeah, I said, well, this is not okay. I made a video about it, and here's the proof. What's going on with this? Then they said, oh yeah, this and that. I had to install a program, and there was another guy that also that's really knowledgeable about this stuff. I mean, I'm not an engineer. I just only know if there is a problem, I need to fix it, because I don't know, it's not. I mean, if you play a game like Destiny 2 or a competitive game, you don't want this lag. Like, it feels sluggish. Like there's something running in the background, and you know, it feels like this. Your system should be faster, but it's not. It's like rubber banding, or I don't know how to explain. It's just sluggish lag. That kind of feeling. When you open something, and then it's just weird. It just feels off. Anyway, they could see that there was a problem, and yeah, it was with the EC sensor and all that stuff. And even when we tried monitoring the motherboard for with these probes, thermal, or the you know, try to probe it, like measure things with a multimeter, everything, voltages, everything, it was way out of whack. It was not, you know, and it was on an Asus what is it again, the Asus ROG Crosshair X370 Hero, and that motherboard is just, yeah, what can I say about it, it's crap. They should never release it. It's so crap. But it's all on AMD. It's never Asus. They never make any mistakes, and they never fix anything, because these problems are still there, and these problems date from 2018, maybe even before that, even before when I was still at the FX 990 FX. What was the name? The Sabertooth R 3.0. I had not similar but short issues like this. But yeah, that's 2016, and they still haven't learned, and they never will. And the problem is that Gigabyte uses the same EC sensor and have no issues with it, zero, none. And if you uninstall the program, there is nothing left on the system anymore. I know this because I had Gigabyte boards. I had 2 Gigabyte boards. No, I think 3 even. The 90FX UD3, and I had a UD5, 2 UD3s, different versions, and then a UD5. And yeah, I had way less issues than on any Asus board. And this is weird. And a friend of mine also has Gigabyte and MSI boards. Minor to no issues over to Asus RG, and one issue after another. I mean, they function fine, and the hardware is very good. The BIOS looks good, but yet there's so much erraticness. I mean, the BIOS, for instance, there's so much crap in it nobody knows what all these settings do. Like 80% of all these settings don't do anything, or people don't know what to do with it, or it doesn't do anything. I mean, why add stuff? And it's even double. Some settings are even double. In a hidden menu, you have the same setting. I mean, what kind of crap is that? And I mean, you know, for something so expensive, they should know better. But anyway, the BIOS looks very nice, though. I mean, it works, and you know, but yeah, it's just the EC sensor and all that stuff. But anyway, okay. Long story short, this works. It had like you know, these problems, blah blah blah. So then they did some research on it, and they decided to give us a free motherboard, which was very nice, and I'm really happy with it. And indeed, a lot of things were fixed, but still the software, I got a new, well, it's not new now, but the new Asus ROG Crosshair X470 Hero Wi-Fi. And it's a very nice board. I have a love-hate relation with it. I like the aesthetics of it, and yeah, to some people it's important. For me, it's not the most important, but it just feels good. Everything, it just, you buy an experience, like, you know, the box, everything. I like the whole ROG theme. I like that. But that's about it. The performance is good, but is it better than any other motherboard? I don't think so. It doesn't make any sense. I mean, I don't think it functions, performs better than any board. I mean, how would you even measure such a thing? I mean, no. It's just all... and there's a lot of... a lot of... so much stuff on it that it's impossible to... you know, to make it work properly, you have to have like a very good software engineer, which they don't have apparently, otherwise you don't have these problems. And they don't take any advice. I mean, you know, but I this motherboard is better, you know, as in they the voltages are much better, everything is better than the X370, like much better, and it's still running. Well, you know, except for the software issue, it's still running fine. I have, you know, sometimes with RAM, system memory, I have some problems, but nothing too. It's finally worked, but that took like 1.5 years or something. So many BIOS updates, and then you try a new BIOS, it's a beta BIOS, and all that bullshit, you know. They take us for a bunch of dumbasses, and they take it for beta testers, and you know, people complain about it, and then they fix something. It shouldn't be like that, man. They should have their own R&D. They have no, I don't even know if they still have an R&D. I mean, their own, their own R&D engineer quit, actually, because of these problems, and people say, oh, it isn't. I mean, it's there on the forum. I mean, I saw it. And it's nothing, I mean, he did the right thing. I mean, nothing bad to this guy. And he did his best, and he helped us a lot, and he's a tremendous asset. But no, he should know better by than to work for Asus ROG, because they're a bunch of, I mean, it shouldn't be like this, you know. I don't want to sound like a salty ass, but it's just no, it should not be like this. But anyway, I got this new X470 motherboard, and it is working, yeah, quite nicely, to be perfectly honest. But still, in games, issues after issue, and I could not figure out what it was. And so, yeah. Now, in the present, what I was talking before was way back. I was, you know, I was having some mouse issues that whenever I try to, and I thought it was a net .NET frame issue, because when that breaks down, you have mouse issues, you have all kinds of issues. But I mean, I repaired Windows, and same issue. Okay, so I decided to do the ArmoryCrate uninstall. Yeah, it did uninstall the program. Of course, it's designed to do that, but still. It didn't. And here's the proof. After this tool, I run CCleaner in order to make sure everything is fine, repair registry, whatever. Oh, that's the other one. This one. This was still in a registry. ArmoryCrate data collection, ArmoryCrate diagnostic, and that kind of crap. And I could fold it open, and there's a whole list of other crap. And here's Asus Tech. Yet again, more stuff. I have nothing else Asus installed. And GPU Tweak, I don't have that installed, but still, it's here in the registry for some reason. I had it installed maybe a while back, but I uninstalled it. And even this, yeah, it's still there. It's still there. After the uninstall tool, this crap was still there, so I had to remove it manually. Even the CCleaner couldn't remove it. I mean, what's this? What kind of crap is that? Yeah, so we used this one, and yeah, then I got, you know, just this crap. I uninstalled it, and yeah, but still I was having weird issues, like mouse issues in game Destiny 2 issues, like mouse behavior, everything. It just didn't work, still laggy. Then I was going to services, and what do I see here? Armory life update. I disabled this, but I before I should make a screenshot, but these, I can assure you, these Asus was finked. Okay, so live update com service. I have nothing Asus installed, so I don't know why this is. Control service, update service, cert. What is this? What? Why is it still here? I have nothing Asus installed. It's still here, still in the service stuff. So the only way to get rid of this crappy cancerous software, and by a cancer I mean like cancer means that it spreads and causes issues. That's what cancer actually means. And this software spreads like a cancer through your whole operating system. There's no way to get rid of it. The only way is to reinstall Windows, or you have to be like forensic and go whole deep in your system. But even then, it's still, you don't, I mean, there's so many stuff in Windows registry, and Windows itself is buggy as well, so that doesn't help either. Yeah, that's it. I mean, this is the last Asus motherboard I ever buy. I'm done with it, and I spent so many years, well, that's a bit exaggerated, but I spent several years of annoyment and issues, and I don't have the same issue on Gigabyte board. So I think I will my next board is going to be a Gigabyte, and I'm going to put up this motherboard for sale and get a Gigabyte one, because I am done with Asus ROG, and I will call them asses from now on, because that's what they are. They're a bunch of asses, assholes. They don't give a shit about people. They don't give a shit about their customers, clearly. I mean, if they do, then why haven't they fixed it? I mean, do you really think that, you know, if you can make a software, and especially with Armoury Crate, I mean, Asus IL Suite, Fan Expert, all that crap is cramped in Armoury Crate, and it's still not fixed. So you make all this software, and maybe it's developed by different teams. They're not talking to each other because apparently they cannot communicate with each other for whatever reason. And to put it in one big software called Armoury Crate, and it conflicts with each other. It conflicts with each other, causing all kinds of stupid problems. And nobody understands how, or I mean, if you're not looking for it, let me put it like that. If you're not looking for these problems and you don't know about Asus ROG software and all that stuff, it's very time consuming, and you know, to, in order to do research, in order to find what the problem is. But this is, I'm not saying that all PC problems are caused by this, but this could be. It's a very high chance. If you have an Asus motherboard, laptop, or anything Asus installed, please uninstall it. It's crap. It's the most buggy software I ever encountered, and I will never ever install anything Asus again. But the fun part is, well, it's actually not fun. You need the software to, in order to get updates. It's only via Armoury Crate. You know, the lighting software is also buggy, by the way. There are three pieces of software that are buggy. First, Asus AllSuite 3, extremely buggy. It I mean, anyone who is saying otherwise is just plain lying, or just putting wool over their eyes, or just ignorant about it. The second is the lighting software. I forgot the name, the RGB. Maybe it's somewhere here. And they still, you know, deal into all that crap. What's the name again? I forgot. The easy update. There's nothing easy about it. Yeah, why put demon tools here? I mean, what the fuck? Guys are so out of whack. Aura. Ah, it's Aura software. Here, it's from 2018. They stopped. Yeah, it's from 2018. They stopped updating it because they implemented in Armoury Crate. Everything is all in Armoury Crate now. So you have to install Armoury Crate in order to have all these programs. Even though you don't want the Fan Expert, after an update, it's still getting installed, and I was still having these EC problems. Not that the fans would ramp up and down, because I have a program called AquaSuite, which is working perfectly fine and controlling my pump and my fans and everything. So that's working perfectly fine, and I have an what is it? A Lamptron fan controller. So no, almost nothing is plugged into the yeah, only a little 40 millimeter fan, which is not very important because I don't want to have it controlled by the by the fan controller or something else. It's not very important. I have it on a VRM. I don't know why it's not getting hot any. I could better remove it. But anyway, that's another. I digress. That's another story. But anyway, so yeah, it's crap. Yeah, that was that's like, you know, and these programs are cramped into it, and you need it in order to control your RGB lighting. And I tried several programs and in order. I was looking on the internet, and I tried several programs, and yeah, I couldn't find anyone except OpenRGB, and I will put a link in the description below in order for you to download it. If people really want to get rid of this Asus Asus, I will call them Asus from now on, because that's, they don't deserve Asus. Asus ROG. Yeah, they. If you want to get rid of all this software, just do a clean on install. But even then, if you have there's another catch. It's even in BIOS. This company is so crap that even in BIOS, they have a thing that whenever you restart or do anything different, it pop up. There's a setting. It will pops up for you in order to install. If you want to install this Armory Crate software, download and install it. It's in their BIOS. It's so deeply embedded into everything. This is just this. This is. I don't know what to call it. It's crap. It's stupid. It should not be like that. But anyway, that's another story. But yeah, you have to disable it in BIOS. It's in, I don't know. It's in RLG services, I think, or something. And you have to disable it. Otherwise, you keep getting this stupid message the whole time if you don't have it installed. It's fucking stupid. Yeah. So OpenRGB, it's working perfectly fine. It's working better than. And it's a free program, by the way. You can, you know, donate to them. It's a free program, and it works better than any software Asus ever had, have, and ever will produce. It works better. Yeah, I haven't had a single issue. And there's nothing installed, nothing running in the background. You just open it up. It has to have access to the system bus in order to detect the memory. I have Trident C Neo kit. Four sticks of them, 32 gigabyte, and yeah, in order to see that, and my CPU block, it has to have access to the system bus, and yeah, it just works like that. I never had an issue, never, ever, and I used it for like, I don't know, 2 weeks maybe now, and I don't have any issue. You save a profile, and you load the profile, and that's it. And the colors are better. Well, the colors are not better, but it's everything is easier. It's better in every possible way. The Asus software is just, man, I cannot I cannot be I have to take a sip of drink. Anyway, yeah, that's the issue. But don't take it only from me. Here, there's a guy all the way from 2019, Armory Crate damaged my whole system. And this is pretty much the same stuff I had on my PC. After reset, first boot, the device seems to work fine, blah blah blah, restart, install updates, and I mean, stutter a lot and slow even in simple file transfer. See, that's the problem I was having too. And I could not figure out. It's not all the time. Sometimes it's like, sometimes they need to find, like, or I don't know how you call it. Like they're pulling data or something. You know, they're pulling data and all of a sudden your system becomes slow. I don't know. High CPU usage as well. That's a bad sign. If your CPU, if there's a software that uses a lot of CPU and is basically not an important program, then it's a buggy software. Just, it's spyware. Just uninstall it. Do a fresh install, whatever. It's just, you know. I mean, here. Unbelievable. But a little help is offered by Asus on this forum. Yeah, they don't help at all. Here, this is from 2019. Right, Asus doesn't give a shit. Yeah, they really don't. Here, the only way is fresh install. What the fuck is with this, man? Yeah, this guy, what is some fanboy? If there's an issue by Debian, FPS has nothing to do with the app. What kind of idiot is this? Yeah. Yeah, you cannot. It's the only way. This is, I mean, here. So many problems here. High CPU utilization. This is on a new motherboard even. This is on a new one here. I mean, I can't go on and on here. So far, Elm Recreate installed, causing crashes, issues. I mean, I can go on and on and on. I mean, Google for yourself, do your research. This software is crap. Avoid this company like the plague. I will never ever. Well, the only thing, to be, I have to be honest, I have the Asus ROG Strix Scope RX, and I really like that keyboard. The keyboard is, yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. And I mean, I give credit where credit is due. And yeah, this keyboard is, yeah, I like it. I mean, I have nothing bad to say about it. I mean, it works. It's sturdy. It's working fine. And yeah, it's a gamer keyboard. They say it's a gaming keyboard, and I think this is a truly gaming keyboard because it has gaming features, everything. But then, you know, I don't want to make, you know, any advertisement for Asus, but yeah, this is the one I like. But anyway, we're talking about motherboard and software issues, and yeah, this is, I mean, here, this is problem. I mean, I can go, if you go Google Asus ROG issues, problems, I mean, one after the other. I mean, this has to stop. This really has to stop, this nonsense. It makes no sense. It's not needed. This is not needed. I don't know what Asus is doing or thinking. Why to install all this crappy software? Yeah, this is, I mean, but people still buying it, and people don't understand how a lot of things work, and they're just in denial. A lot of people are in denial. They say, oh no, Asus doesn't do this because I'm a customer for whatever, how many years. But trust me, they're doing it. I mean, the proof is here in the pudding. I mean, you know, I can, here, how can you even be more clear? I don't know how to be more clear. I mean, yeah, believe it or not, this is really the stuff that was still running and probably is still running, so I have to do a fresh Windows install in order to get rid of this crap. This utter cancer crap, Asus cancer crap. That's unacceptable. I had like many times, you know, I had Gigabyte boards. I don't have an MSI motherboard because, yeah, I simply don't like MSI. Or don't like. Yeah, these boards didn't look very appealing to me in order to buy them. So that was, yeah. Yeah, it's, you know, that's the only reason actually. The first board I bought was an Gigabyte, and then yeah, I was having some minor issues, and I was learning and make a lot of mistakes, and yeah, for some reason I went to Asus. Yeah, what was it? Asus 990FX. Sabertooth 2.0, and then I went to the 3.0. And yeah, they were working fine, but yeah, the problem started as soon as they entered the Ryzen era, like with the X370. That board was just the worst board you can have in all boards. The RAM compatibility was crap, everything was crap, everything was just, it should never be released. And yeah, if you like, it was on Kit Guru as well. They talked to Asus ROG, and yeah, it was just cringe to watch. And there was an engineer there, and he explained also that, oh yeah, it has to be the reviewer's fault because you have, you know, if you, you know, it was a simple question, and I mean, you can't just be honest about it. I mean, why bullshit so much about this? Why always so much bullshit? It's just, you know, it's unsustainable. People are not stupid. People don't buy this crap anymore, because, yeah, it's like, oh, if you put the RAM sticks in wrong, or you know, it's all about connection. I mean, what do you mean all about connection? Of yes, it is connection, and if a RAM slot is a little bit dirty or whatever, yes, it can cut it, but has nothing to do with validating or like, you know, as in they test you know, how you call this, validation. You know, like they test so many RAMs, sticks, and etc., etc. It has nothing to do with that collection. It was so bullshit. I can leave a link in the description below as well. And I think Leo was even from KidGuru was also a bit annoyed by these stupid answers Asus gave. And at last moment, there was a sales pitch because yeah, they really didn't provide any answers. They have nothing. They didn't know what to say basically, I think. And then there was a sales pitch, and oh, we do the mace validation out of everybody, and blah blah blah, whole blah yappity yap, and but it's all bullshit. I mean, if you validate, I mean, I go over at overclock.net, and I mean, this it means jack shit, and I don't know. You can just as well use it as toilet paper, this QVL, because. I mean, even this guy on KidGuru and on Overclock.net and YouTubers, whatever, used RAM that is on the QVL list, didn't work. They ordered the same kit, also didn't work. They bought the kit that wasn't on the QVL list, and it works. And that's just, you know. And I was talking to a guy that had a Gigabyte board, an X370... Master or something, I don't know, I'm not familiar with Gigabyte anymore, but yeah, not a single issue. And they have their own issues, but not the same issue as on, I mean, they are solvable, but Asus made such a big mess of everything that I don't know, they just, in my opinion, they need to fire their software engineer, because this guy has clearly no idea what he is doing, and he's just making a software like look like nice and everything, but he has no idea what he's doing. Or there's something with their R&D again with their R&D department. Well, I wouldn't say again, because with John Sandstrom, Elmore, everything was actually, I wouldn't say better, but at least he talked to people, and now we don't have that anymore. They just don't give a shit about it anymore. And yeah, that's why he resigned, because, you know, he was dealing with a lot of problems, and, you know, and I understand that. I mean, it's not nothing bad about it. He's an amazing guy. I don't know him personally, but he's an amazing guy. And, you know, he's also limited by what he can tell and his knowledge, maybe. I don't know him. I don't know his expertise. But I talked to another guy. It was an engineer. I won't pronounce his name because, yeah, maybe he doesn't like it. But anyway, and... Yeah, we did some tests and we saw that there were a lot of issues on ROG motherboards. So yeah, and they still haven't solved it, and it goes from bad to worse with this Armory Crate crap. And yeah, I don't know. I hope they're gonna fix it. If they're not gonna fix it, then yeah, this will be my last ROG motherboard I will ever buy. But yeah, you can see it here. Even on this thing, yeah, the new formula, Crosshair 8 X570 formula. I mean, that board is 500 euros plus in my country. I'm from the Netherlands, so yeah, this is just yeah. And here you can see the move of Asus motherboards. Feeling that the other motherboard may will offer an even worse. Yeah, see, another guy is just fed up with all this bullshit. Yeah, I mean, you can go on and on and on. I mean, I can make this video over like 1 or 2 or 3 hours. And put even more quote unquote proof, or you know, do even more research in depth. But I think I make my point. The software is crap. Don't ever install anything from Asus ever again. Not a single thing. Not even audio servers. Nothing at all. Asus is crap. I mean, the software is crap. Anything else? I mean, but here they don't Yeah, they don't give a shit. They don't answer. You don't get any. I sent Asus an email, like Asus.org an email about a year ago, and I still haven't got an answer. They don't give a shit. They don't give a single shit about their customer. The only one who gave a shit doesn't work for them anymore. That was Elmer John Sandstrom from Sweden, I guess. I don't know where this guy's from, but anyway, it doesn't matter. That was the only guy who was really with you know, with the customer, talking to the customer. If there was an issue, you know, you can talk to them on overclock.net. But they got so many issues and backfires that, yeah, it would be impossible for him to do his job properly. And yeah, then he resigned because of all these issues. And I think he did a right thing. I think nobody should be it shouldn't be like that. They should you know, they should listen to him. He's an excellent guy. He's an expert. But yeah, like I said, they don't give a shit. So yeah, that's my little thing about the software. And if people have issues, I feel you know, feel the need in order to inform people and warn people from all this crap. Don't ever install it. Don't even, I mean, you know, I don't know. I would say steer clear from Asus ROG, but I mean, yeah, it's just, I don't know. It's, if you look at other, I think Gigabyte would be the best option for now. And I think I will put this motherboard up for sale because I had a bit of enough of this thing. And because of all this stuff, because even when I use OpenRGB, the RGB software, I have to still access the system bus, and I still think it causes some issues. There is no way for me to know. I don't have the software. I'm not an engineer, but I still think because other people don't have that issue, it must be the motherboard. There's nothing else. I don't have anything running on the background that can cause these issues except the Asus ROG software, or it must be some flaw in the wire of the motherboard, like the EC sensor or whatever. It's just yeah, but it's also the BIOS. The BIOS is the buggiest thing ever. Like they update the EC sensor through BIOS. I don't have firmware. I don't know what, if it's worked with any other motherboard. I have no idea. I don't care actually. It just doesn't work. So if there is an issue with the motherboard and with the BIOS EC sensor, they made a new BIOS. So it accessed the sensor on a different way or something, and then they implement something else, and it also didn't work, and they offer no support for it anymore. Like, you know, they tried to bypass the system bus, and they tried several things, but I mean, they have no idea what they're doing. I don't know. It's just it's just stupid. Do in order to make a good motherboard, just do research before, put it on a test bench, and do all this. If you make a mistake, admit it. Fix it and move on. That's how you should do things. I mean, if you do it like this, like Asus here, there's not a single answer from Asus. He has an Asus logo, but I don't know he works for Asus. I don't think he does. But anyway, yeah, not a single answer from Asus. Let me check if there's on the end. Nope, not an answer. Ah, this is the thing I was, this was the thing actually, nice that he got this, this is in a BIOS, you have to disable it. What is this? Why is this a thing in a BIOS? Why? I mean, what the fuck? Yeah, I got blue screen, it just, I don't believe, he tried to uninstall and blue screen, man, the problems are, I mean, this is endless, really, really endless. Like I said, I can make a video as long as I want on issues with this software. And in my opinion, they need to pull it. They need to pull it from downloads, fix it, or bring an update that fixes a lot of this stuff. Like, you know, at least if you install, you know, if you uninstall it, remove it completely from your system, but everything is so embedded and everything works and with each other and etc 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 etc. It doesn't function. It doesn't function well. So yeah, this is Yeah, but even the EC sensor, I mean, this thing you can buy on AliExpress for 15 bucks, 15 euros, you have 10 of these sensors. That's how cheap these things are. They don't cost anything. You can buy it on AliExpress. Why in the holy hell, in such an expensive motherboard, place such a cheap sensor? And it's actually imp an important sensor as well. I mean, go with Nofto or something, whatever it's called. They're much better. They're much better. I mean, Gigabyte uses it. ASRock uses these Nofto sensor things. They work much. They are better. I mean, you know, it's like it's a thing about software. The Asus software and the sensor. Sensor is not 100% reliable. The software of Asus is not very, very good. It's not good at all, to say the least. So yeah, you create problem on problem on problem on problem. I really don't understand what's behind their thinking process on how do you want to make you know, they're not enthusiastic. If you I'm an enthusiast, I want things are not perfect. This is not a perfect world. I perfectly understand that. But this is just crap. This should not be like this. Asus ROG is one of the biggest out there. I mean, it's not like they lack money or anything. They have bulks of money. I mean, there's no problem in that. So I just cannot get my head around it why things like this still exist. Problems like this should not exist. But yet they do. And yeah, then I feel the need in, you know, to inform people, warn people of this crappy stuff. And yeah, hopefully Asus is watching this and they're gonna f do something. I mean, I tested before, like, you know, with the X370 motherboard. I want to, yeah, I want to test. I can test, and yeah, if that's what they want, then yeah, they can contact me. And yeah, I want to test and then send them some stuff. And because this has to stop, this crap. This is not nice. It should not be like this. I mean, you know. But anyway, I'm rambling on and on and on about the same thing. Yeah, this is my little spiel. I had to make. I felt like making it because it was extremely bugging me, extremely upset by it. Because I mean, I just want to play a game, and I'm an enthusiast. I want things to be good, and I know Asus can do better than this, but I don't know if they ever will or gonna be better. I mean, these problems date from 2018, as far as, and probably even from 2016, as far as I saw. Maybe they have a new software engineer. That needs to learn a lot. I don't know. You don't get any answers. They don't respond to emails, problems. They give bullshit answers like, oh, do a fresh Windows install, do this, or do an RMA. That's not gonna fix the problem. This has to stop. This is bullshit. I mean, I had a Gigabyte board, like I said before, UD5 had some issues with it. Contacted Gigabyte. Oh, they send an email to Taiwan. The headquarters, the same as from Asus, and yeah, I got a new BIOS and it fixes the problem within a week. Within a week, there was like I can't remember the problem. It was not that minor or not that important, but still, within a week, I got an answer with a zip file with a new BIOS, and it actually fixed the problem. I mean, it can be done. It can be done. Just do it, just like Nike. Just do it. So yeah, okay, guys. That yeah, is my little spiel, and that's like an yeah, about their software and what is causing it. I can put some links in the description below for you guys to see for yourself and go download the Open RGB software. And it's very easy. They also have their own Discord server, so you can ask questions. Yeah, I think it's one of the better programs, softwares for RGB software. So I really like it. So, okay, guys. Well, thanks for listening to me for the rambling, but I think I made my point. And yeah, I hope you will understand a little bit better about Asus ROG and how they work and how yeah to do all this. So yeah, in short, there is no way of the uninstall tool doesn't do anything. CCleaner doesn't do anything. Reaver uninstaller. The only thing is to do a fresh Windows install to get rid of this cancerous software. The only way. There is no other way. Yeah, or you have to go like for a week, go into registry, and even in registry, it's there. It's so deeply embedded. It's better just to, and maybe it fucked something up. So you know, which you can't see, and if you can't see, you cannot fix. So do the wise thing. Do a fresh install or a reinstall of Windows. That's the best. I'm gonna do a fresh install after I end this video, and see how everything goes and goes from there. And then, we'll see how. We'll see how it ends up. So, okay, all right, guys. Well, thanks for listening to my rambling again. And if you have any questions, please, leave a comment below. And if I can, I will help you. I will answer it. And if you have suggestions, I'm also open to suggestions. And if you like this, then put a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more of hopefully not these videos, but if you want to see more. More of this of my channel, then subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.